In our last video, we had seen the creation of merchandise category and assigning the characteristics to that so that you can create variants based on that when you create the article for that particular merchandise category. So variant is like what we know, that it is the different version of the same material but with different attributes. For example, like a shirt with different colors, or shirt with different size, shirt with different colors and size. Okay, but eventually this is the same material, single material. Okay, so when you are creating a purchase order for that material, the system will ask you to enter the variant quantities in the purchase order. Okay, you have to enter the variant quantities and send it to the vendor. Okay, if there is a way to automate that variant quantity in the purchase order through something called as value and quota scale. To create our value scale or quota scale, you have to go through logistics, retailing, master data, material group data, characteristics, value scale, quota scale. First we have to create the value scale for the characteristics. So our characteristics is WW color. I'm going to create PVS01. So this gives the list of characteristics. So I'm going to Woolworths color value scale, save it. Okay. Now create a quota scale for that value scale. You can create another, let us create another value scale, WW size. So WW VS02. Okay. Woolworths size VS. So I'm going to create a quota scale for each value scale. So WW color, my value scale was WWVS01, and I'm going to QS01. Let me create a quota scale. So when I'm creating a purchase order, what should be the quota for these variants is what I'm saying. For example, white is the fast moving, so let me say as 25. Black is the least moving, so let me say 10, 35. So 10, okay. Blue L, so 20, 20. So we have got 30, 40, 85, and the remaining as 15%. Okay, Woolworths color quota scale. Okay, you can create many quota scales, among which if you want to mark any one as default, you can make it as the default indicator. Okay, similarly for size, WW size, I think it's 2. I'm going to create a new one. So what should be the size? I want 10 10 20 20 10 10. So how much it came to? We had got 40 40 80, so 20. Woolworths size quota scale, and let me mark this as a default. Okay, we have created a value scale based on our quota scale based on our value scale. So now let us check a material slash nmm42. So there's a material. I'm just checking. Not at all the variants. Okay, this has all the sizes and three colors, white, black, and blue. Now let me create a sales order for this material slash NME21N. So this is our material 15. I'm ordering 100 pieces for the site W001. You could see that the variance numbers are automatically populated. Of course, I'll be able to make any changes here. I don't want the small black. Instead, I want to distribute that quantity to here. I'll still be able to make the changes accordingly. Okay. However, so this reduces the our effort in maintaining the quantities for the variants manually. Now let us see what happens when there are multiple value scales and quota scales. So let me create a new, let us change and check that. Let us change that default indicator in that quota scale. So what is that? WW color was our first one. So I uncheck this default indicator. I uncheck this also. Okay, now let me create a new quota scale for let us copy from QS0. So here we will change that. I don't want yellow in the first place, so I'll remove that. I will make it as 20 20. So I have created a alternate quota scale. Similarly, let me create another one for so I don't want extra large. So how much it is? So how much it came to? Yes, we have 50 and 50. Okay, so now we have two quota scales and two value scales. So now let us create a so it is asking what is the quota scale I have to take and what is the value scale I can take for this. Okay, so let us choose a new one. Similarly, yes, so now the quotas has been taken according to the new scale which we had created. Okay, so we can automate this process for specific sites also. For example, if the DC orders, the ratio should be different. If the store orders, the ratio should be different. We can do this kind of setting. So we can set the quota scales as per the site. So automatically generate the quota scale per site and merchandise category. So let me create a new one. My value scale is WWVS01 my merchandise category is WW main. My customer is site is so WWBS03. Similarly, WWBS01. So WW main W100 WWBS01. Okay, so let us give one to the distribution center where all the things are covered. So, and QS. WWBS02, WW main, W001, WWQS02, VS02, WW main, W100, WWQS04. They had assigned the different ones. Slash and ME21N. W001. Let us see the quantities. Okay, so it comes to 43, 20, and 37. So in the new screen, we'll create a purchase order for the same material but for the different site, ME21N. W100. See, here the quantity is 43, 20 and 37 for W100 site. Okay, but for this site the quantity is 38, 31, 31. Okay, so the system automatically proposes a different quota scale based on the site because of our assignment. So this is all about the quota scales and value scales. Okay, so let us see what happens when you modify any characteristics. Okay, so I go to the characteristics maintenance. Material group data. Characteristics. Characteristics values. So WW, okay, size let it be. So I'm going to create another size, 5L, 4X, 5L. So you come to the quota scale, reconcile with characteristics, which means whenever there is a to be added in size, right? So VS02. It says, do you want to reconcile? List shows yes. I want to see the list. It says new characteristics has been added. Fine. Post it. Whether you want to include this new size in your quota scale, that you can do it here. Size is 02. Okay, anything is fine with this. So there is a new one, so I can include that. When I create a new purchase order, this new characteristics and the corresponding quota will be automatically picked up. So this is all about the value scale and quota scale, which you can find it interesting, and this is most useful in the in the fashion industry, apparels, where the people decide on what is the quantity and size that they have to buy. Okay, so practice it and we will catch up with the other video. If you liked this video, please refer this to your friends, subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. Take care. Bye.